திஸ் இஸ் அ பார்ட் டூ ஆஃப் ஜென்ரல் கிளாசஸ் ஆக்ட். வி ஹவ் சீன் அப் டு செக்ஷன் 14 ஆஃப் ஜென்ரல் கிளாசஸ் ஆக்ட் இன் த பார்ட் 1. நவ் வி வில் சீ த ரிமைனிங் திங்ஸ். செக்ஷன் 15, பவர் டு அப்பாயிண்ட் இன்க்ளூட் பவர் டு அப்பாயிண்ட் எக்ஸ் அஃபிஷியோ. எக்ஸ் அஃபிஷியோ மீன்ஸ் அப்பாயிண்டிங் ஏ பர்சன் பை டெசிக்னேஷன். ஃபார் எக்ஸாம்பிள், சம்படி ஹேஸ் டு பி ரெப்ரசன்டட் இன் ஏ போர்டு, ஆர் சம்படி ஹேஸ் டு பி ரெப்ரசன்டட் இன் ஏ கமிட்டி, தென் த பவர் டு அப்பாயிண்ட் இன்க்ளூஸ் பவர் டு அப்பாயிண்ட் ஏ பர்சன் எக்ஸ் அஃபிஷியோ. யூ கேனாட் சே அவர் ஜென்ரல் மேனேஜர் ஆப்ரேஷன்ஸ் வில் பி அ பார்ட் ஆஃப் தி கமிட்டி மெம்பர், ஆர் அவர் ஜென்ரல் மேனேஜர் ஆப்ரேஷன்ஸ் வில் பி த டைரக்டர் ஃபார் தி போர்ட் ஆஃப் டைரக்டர்ஸ் போர்டு டைரக்டர்ஸ் போர்டு லைக் தட் தட் இஸ் எக்ஸ் அஃபிஷியோ. பவர் டு அப்பாயிண்ட் இன்க்ளூட்ஸ் த பவர் டு அப்பாயிண்ட் எக்ஸ் அஃபிஷியோ. தென் 16, பவர் டு அப்பாயிண்ட் இன்க்ளூஸ் த பவர் டு டிஸ்மிஸ் பவர் டு டிஸ்மிஸ் ஆர் பவர் டு சஸ்பெண்ட். தட் இஸ் ஹூ இஸ் த பர்சன் அப்பாயிண்டிங் ஆஸ் ஒன்லி த பவர் டு டிஸ்மிஸ் த பர்சன். ஃபார் எக்ஸாம்பிள், இஃப் மேனேஜிங் டைரக்டர் இஸ் அப்பாயிண்டிங் எ பர்சன், த ஜென்ரல் மேனேஜர் கனாட் டிஸ்மிஸ் ஹிம், த ஜென்ரல் மேனேஜர் கனாட் சஸ்பெண்ட் ஹிம். He has to recommend to the managing director, this is a problem, this person is like this, so we have to dismiss him. Then the managing director should take a decision to dismiss him. Whoever is the appointing authority is the authority for suspend and dismissal. Then substitution of functionaries. One person can officiate in some other person also. Next is successors, section 18. That is, in case of corporations, companies, it includes the person who has acquired the asset from that, who is the successor to the company. A company might have been purchased by some other person. So, it includes the other person or successor also. Then, construction of notification and etc. issued under the enactments. If a notice or order, anything is issued under an act, it has the power of the act. All the provisions of the act will be applicable to the order so issued, the notification so issued. This is section 20. Then 21, power to issue include power to add, amend and vary, rescind. Whoever issues the order has only the power to alter it. If the secretary, chief secretary is issuing one order, only he has the power to vary it, he has to correct it or he has to modify it. For example, one person is put in a jail as per the order of the central government authority as preventive detention. The state government cannot release the person. Only the person who issued order to put the person in jail under preventive detention can only release him. He only has the order to modify, amend or rescind the order. That is section 21. Section 22, making rules and bylaws on different dates. An act may come to effect from one day, one date. Rules or regulations made under the act may come into force in another date. If there is any action before the act has come into force, it will not be valid. They can initiate action. The validity comes only after the act has come into force from the effective date of the act. This is section 22. Section 23, provisions applicable for making rules or bylaws. This is regarding rules, making rules. The parliament makes an act. Parliament is busy with so many things. They cannot make a detailed provisions for everything. So what they do, they make an act. In principle, they may make everything. And for some clarification, they ask the executive, that is the government secretary or deputy director, director, all these people, the concerned department, CBDT, like that. They ask the other people to frame rules for the act. Under the provisions of the act, they have to frame the rules. This is called administrative law. A law by the administrators. Normally, the parliament and legislature or lawmakers, they only can make law. Executive, like government machinery, the ministry, council of ministers and government officials are executors of the law. Court give an interpretation of law and assist in enforcing the law. But here the administrators, the executives are given some lawmaking power within the framework given by the lawmakers. For example, they make a law, they ask the other people to frame rules. It also has the force of law. For example, the lawmakers may make an act, these household articles to be taxed at 18%, electronic goods to be taxed at 24%, like that they will make the law. But which is coming under the electronic goods, which is coming under the household articles, all things are not clear. So the rules and regulations will be made by the executive people. They will say that these are the things, this much is rate, this thing, this rate. Based on this, they make their rules. Companies Act is there, companies rules is there. For everything there will be rule. That is an operative part within the framework of law. The rules made by the executive people. This section 23 gives a procedure for that. Whenever you are making a rule, first you make a draft rule, put it as a notification for the general public, accept the objections from them, then give effect to the notification. Then give the final rules and regulations. After publication, get the objections, taking into their views also, give a final shape, and then only the notification should be published in the official gazette. 24. Continuation of orders, etc. issued under an act, repealed or re-enacted. If it is already an order is issued, it should be continued. For example, an order issued under Companies Act 1956 has to be continued under the new act, re-enacted act of 2013. Section 25, recovery of fines. Recovery of fines, how to recover? It says according to the Indian Penal Code, how they are recovering. There is a procedure in the Indian Penal Code for recovery of fine that will be applicable for all other act. Next, 26, provision as to offences punishable under two or more enactments. If an act is punishable under two acts, take only one. Don't punish a person twice for the same act. This is in a constitution also. You cannot punish a person twice for a same act. Either in this act or other act, you punish him under only one act for an offense. Next, 27, meaning of service by post. If the act says to be served by post, what you have to do? Properly addressed, properly stamped by registered post. Then it will be deemed to be a proper serving of post. But whenever it says it is by registered post with acknowledgement due, you have to go only by that. Then 28, citation of enactments. How to cite the enactments? You should say the short name of the, short title of the act, followed by the number of the act and the year of the act. Section 30 says, this is applicable, this general clauses is applicable to the ordinance also. What is an ordinance? The lawmakers are the parliament people and the MLAs in state. When the assembly is not in session, when the parliament is not in session, there may be some urgent need to pass an act. In that case, the executive people make the law, prepare the law and get the approval from the assent of the governor or the president. For example, there was an issue on this Jallikattu. At that time, an act was prepared, ordinance approved by the governor, president approval was obtained for that, then it came into force. The ordinance will be having an effect only for 6 months maximum, or till a new act comes. Temporarily, the ordinance is in place. Subsequently, the parliament people will pass an act. If it is not approved by the parliament, the ordinance will lapse. Section 30 of the General Clauses Act says these definitions apply to the ordinance also. This General Clauses Act does not apply to the state act because all the states have their own General Clauses Act. Now, next we will see another topic in another session.